Hi YouTube. Today we are working on a easy breezy crochet hat. These are so easy to make. It literally takes me less than an hour to make this. And all you're gonna need is one spool of yarn of Charisma loop and threads. Now I think I'll buy this at Michael's, but it's easily available online. And I am using a 6.5 crochet hook. These are the crochet plastic hooks from the Dollar Tree. And of course you're going to need scissors. Turn this light on. Okay, so what we're gonna do first is a slip knot. And we're going to create our foundation chain of 30. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is our foundation chain and it's 30. And now we're going to chain 1. And we're going to single crochet in each stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And 30 chain is equals to 30 single crochet. There you go, and this is our foundation row. Now the next one is we're going to chain 1, turn our work around, and we're going to single crochet on this first stitch. There you go, and now we're going to double crochet on every stitch until the end of row. So double crochet, 1 double crochet, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Somehow we'll fix that. And on the last one here, we're gonna insert another one. Another double crochet. There you go. So I'm just gonna trim this here. so it doesn't get in our way again. There you go. Second row is a row of double crochet, and now we're going to chain one, turn our work around, and we're going to single crochet on that first stitch. Okay, and then double crochet in the next stitch and so on. Oh, okay, so we are working on the back loop. Okay, we're inserting our hook in the middle right here and go in the back, and we're double crocheting. So this consists of the rest of the stitch. They're all going to be a row of double crochet, but we're going to do another one just so I can show you guys what I'm doing and how easy it is. We are working on a back loop or the back stitch. Just keep in mind that you should have 30 double crochet in each row. Okay. And on the last one, I'm just going to do a single crochet, and you'll see why at the end. Okay, so let's do another row. Single crochet, I'm sorry. And then we're going to do a single crochet here. And then we're going to do double crochet. I mean, half double crochet. Oh my goodness. Half double crochet on each stitch, working in the back loop. Okay. And you're going to do that until you're almost out of yarn, because we're using the entire spool. So your work should look something like this. Here you go. This is how your work should look like. And what I got here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, and 22 rows of double crochet. And on this last row, I did a single crochet. I'm sorry. 22 rows of half double crochet. And on the last row is a row of single crochet. I only have this much yarn left. So now what we're going to do is we're going to connect. Well, first, I'm going to secure my yarn by pull the yarn all the way through the loop. So now it's nice and secure. So the next thing is we're going to do a slip stitch. You can either do a slip stitch or a single crochet, but I'm going to use a smaller hook because I was using a 6.5. Now I'm going to use a 5.5. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and tie that. And then I'm going to turn my work, and I'm going to go ahead and just do either a slip stitch again or a single crochet. It really doesn't matter because this yarn is so chunky. So let's do a single crochet. crochet. Just want to make sure I stay even here. One last one. There you go. So there's my seam, and as you can see, you can't really tell where the seam is at because of the rows. And when you work in the back row, this is what you get. You get this nice rib stitch look. So one more time, I'm going to pull my yarn through the loop. Gonna pull it all the way through. Just make sure that my yarn doesn't unravel. Okay, there you go. So the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna go ahead and trim my yarn. Okay, and I'm gonna weave this in. I'm gonna use this black needle here, and I'm just gonna go in. In the stitches, hide it, and then go back and trim the excess, make sure not cutting your work. Okay, so now on this end, we're going to thread my needle here with the leftover yarn. We shouldn't need much. And this is all that's left over of the one spool of yarn. Okay, so now I'm just gonna insert my needle here. Make sure I leave a tail. And on each rib, I'm gonna insert my hook. Okay, each rib right here, I'm gonna insert my hook. Don't pull it tight yet, because that's in a few minutes. Each rib, almost there. There you go, one more, and we will end up here. Okay, so now we can pull it. You want to hold on to both tail and pull this one. Oops, make sure you hold on to this one also, and that is how you complete your hat. So what I'm gonna do next is I'm just going to secure it with a couple of knots, maybe one more. That's guaranteed not to go nowhere. I'm gonna cut it, and now I'm just gonna take my crochet hook, insert it from the center here, and I'm just going to pull my stragglers, my yarn, if it lets me. One. Two. One more. Three. There you go. You have a complete hat. So now even the band is nice and thick. Will help you keep warm in this winter. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if so, please thumbs up and remember to subscribe. Thank you for watching 9 a.m. Studio.